Okay, welcome to OGS Studios. I'm Austin Sinara, and today we'll be coming up with a new tutorial for you guys. What we're going to be teaching you guys is basically how to sharpen specific areas in your image. For instance, in this image that we have here for the Flowerful series, there's the flowers all over the model's head. So if you want to sharpen that particular area, and I'm going to show you a technique that I use most of the time to sharpen my images in specific areas that I would like to be more sharpened. Basically, what you would want to do in this scenario is that, let's say you want to sharpen this area of the sunflower, you'd basically duplicate the layer that you have, and right now it's my background layer. Let's say I'll duplicate it, Command J in a Mac and a Control J in a PC. You go to the new layer that you created and name it, just keeping it organized as well. So basically, I'll just name it Sharpen, and this will be the layer that I'll be sharpening. The style that I use is I basically use a layer mask on my image, and then I sharpen the image itself by using high pass. How to do this is you go to your image, and you'll keep it on soft light. Once you do that, you'll go to your filter tab and scroll all the way down to your high pass. Others, high pass. Once you click that, you can basically, what will happen is that the higher radius that you have for your high pass, the more sharpen your image will be. You don't want to have like this effect that I currently have on the image. It's a little bit too sharpened for me. I don't like this the way it looks, so we reduce it to something more realistic. So I'm just going to reduce the radius as well. And also, this depends, the higher the radius or the lower the radius, it depends on how big your image size is. At the moment, my image size is probably quite low. Let me just check it, because this is already a finished, it's a 2000 width and height 133, so it's a little bit low. The original image size was about 5000. to 4000. So basically what I'll do is I'll do the same thing which I just told you right now. So our layer is already on soft light. We go to the filter bar, drop all the way down to your high pass, and as I said, you can just keep it to a level you think will look more realistic in your image, not too sharp as well. So I'll keep it at that, maybe just increase it just a little bit more to 1.5. And you can keep it. You can keep it at a different radius as well. So once I've done that, at the moment the whole image is sharpened, and you just want to have a specific area that is sharpened. And for you to be able to do that, is basically you go to your layer mask and you basically add layer mask to the layer that you have at the moment. You click layer mask, and at the moment you have like the white mask. And to change it, to convert it so that only the image the area that you want to color in is seen. You basically press Command I or Control I, and basically it will change the layer mask, as you saw that I just did that right there. So I'll just go back and then show it to you again. So basically I just held Command and then pressed I, and it changed that, or Control I, and then it changed the layer mask. So basically what has happened is basically the effect that I've done for the sharpening is hidden right now. The only way you'll be able to see it is once I start using my brush with my white paint, and I basically make the area that I want visible on the mask to appear. So I want the flowers to be more sharpened. So what I do here is, let me just look at my opacity for my brush. It's at 100 and my flow is at 100. I'll go to the layer mask, click on it, and then I'll start painting basically over it. And once you're painting, you start seeing at the same time, right there, you start seeing the effects of the flowers becoming more sharp. As you can see, it's becoming more sharp. So let's say you also want to add some sharpening in the eyes as well, just to bring them out, so you can do that as well. And the good thing about having, let's say, the layer mask or having a new layer for the sharpening is basically that maybe after doing all that, you felt that the sharpen area is a little bit too sharp, you can always go to your opacity for that layer and basically just decrease it to a certain level that you might like. But for me, in this situation, I like it sharper, so I'll keep it 100 opacity. And if I'll just press the visible button for the layer on and off, you get to see the effect that has happened to the image. Just one moment. So this is before, as you can see, very very subtle change, but it does give the effect that I would want on a sharpened space. So basically, this is before the image has been edited with the sharpened layer, and this is after. So you can see before, after. So you can also see. Let me move to the eye so you can see even much better. So this is before, after. So you can see there's a little bit of sharpening. So that's a technique that you can use for basically sharpening your images in a specific area by using like a new layer and also using the layer mask. And that's about it for today. So we'll be releasing new tutorials every Tuesday. It'll be Tuesday tutorials. So keep on looking out for that. I hope this tutorial was enlightening on your side. If you didn't know about that technique, and there's a lot of other techniques as well, which you can find online. You can just search for that. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Have a good day.